Are you acquainted with a man named Roger? You know, the piteous fellow hiding away on the balcony. He was a formidable spellblade in times past. Don't let his easy air deceive you. He was wise beyond his years, stout of heart and clear of mind. No more, though. You see him now, ravaged by thorns, muttering and rambling, like he's half dead already. I can't stomach to watch. Take well the lesson, friend. That's how you end up when seduced by those who live in death. When grace is sullied, it rots people from the inside, breaks them.
Always good to see you safe. So, what do you need?
Divinity, have mercy and grant me forgiveness. The road is yet long. A god is not easily felled. But one day without fail, you will have your wish. So please grant me forgiveness, Queen Marika. You, is it? I didn't notice you there. I'll be doing my job, same as ever. Just lay out your arms. Those words were not meant for you. I may be prisoner to you, tarnished lot, but my prayers are mine, and mine alone. Well, I've had my say. I'll be more careful too. No matter. already. No matter.
Little Culver. I'll soon birth thee anew, a sweeting, fresh and pure. My beloved. Have no fear. I will hold thee. Patience. Ye will be countless born. Forever and ever.
Upon my name as Rani the Witch. Mother's rich slumber shall not be disturbed by thee. Foul trespasser. Send word far and wide. Of the last queen of Caria, Renala of the Full Moon. And the majesty of the night she conjureth.
Where did ye flee, my sweetings? Come out from whence ye hide. There are books and light aplenty, dither not. Come out, say I, or will ye be gravestones, to be better born anew? Ah, thou. Is it thy wish to be born anew? To become a sweeting? Reborn of my beloved egg? As a sweeting, fair and fine. assured of thy want to be born anew. Be not alarmed.
I would birth thee.
Waiting for your return. I've decided to leave the Round Table Hold. I'm off in search of a noble scholar known as the Gold Mask, to beg his instruction. We may not meet again for some time. If there's any incantations you wish to learn, now's the moment. Golden Order shine through you.
Ah, hello.
Always good to see you,
son.
He was telling me
that he discovered the mark of the centipede. The centipede is an ancient symbol of the curse mark. As long as whoever finds and uses it is not nefarious by nature, then we may be able to form an alliance. If only I could speak to them in person, and if they were like you, all the better. Maybe I should tell you. Lately, I feel I'm on the precipice of falling into a deep, fathomless slumber. And I have an inkling it could spell trouble for you somehow. So I just wanted to get the apology out of the way beforehand, since you're so scary and all. The battle art you've learned is of the Glintstone family. They were conceived at the Great Academy of Rhea Lucaria, to the north of this castle. In the past, they obeyed laws which contravened the Golden Order. Or so I'm told. Fascinating, isn't it? That the Golden Order was pliable enough to absorb practices that contradicted itself in the past. With the Order broken, twisted, and in need of repair, such adaptability is more important now than ever.
Oh.
Before have I seen two great runes together. Look there! The fingers shudder with exuberance.
Fine work, brave Tarnished. The Greater Will is pleased. You have earned the right to become Elden Lord. Now, seek the Erd Tree and an audience with Queen Marika.
To become Elden Lord and restore the Golden Order. The fingers expect as much from you as they do young Gideon. Take this, a token of farewell.
Now, go forth. Become Elden Lord. Ah, you have returned. What is it? Queen Marika is the vessel of the Elden Ring, carrier of its vision. A god in truth. But after the Elden Ring's shattering, she was imprisoned in the Erd Tree. A grim punishment for shattering the Order, despite her godhood. The fingers speak.
Marika's trespass demanded a heavy sentence. But even in shackles, she remains a god and the Vision's vessel. Confer great runes to become Elden Lord and join Queen Marika as her consort. The fingers have willed it so.
Now you may go.
Well, I took you for no matter. It's all lay out your arms then.
Greetings. Are you here for spirit, Duke? I need to warn you about something. A little while ago, someone started lurking in the wing on the opposite side of the round table. And I can hear, from all the way over there, the howling and wailing of spirits in fear of a curse. I can even hear the repulsive twisted malice in itself. A plethora of spirits in an unceasing cacophony. Can't even imagine how much suffering inflicted to who knows how many souls. Not even the grafting caused anything like this to happen. You should keep your distance. I know you're strong, but please. I can hear it from across the howling. You should keep your...
Well, I see you found another great rune.
Wonderful.
You are a worthy fellow Tarnished indeed. Make the journey to the capital, Laendel, that lies to the east of the Altus Plateau, at the foot of the Erd Tree. The Two Fingers will deny your passage no longer. You may be our best hope. Find your way to the Elden Ring, for we are Tarnished. And we must answer the call of grace.
Greetings. Oh, what have we here? Very well, let us both learn together. Heresy is not native to the world. It is but a contrivance. All things can be conjoined. Oh, what have we here? Very well, let us both learn together. Heresy is not native to the world. It is but a control thing.